gaining time at home, you're gaining time with family, you're gaining time to assess, you're gaining space, you're gaining freedom, all these things that you're gaining. But our minds work like someone in a dark warehouse with a torch. And wherever you shine that torch is where you notice, is what you notice. So really make sure today, guys, what are you noticing? What are you filtering in? Are you filtering in what you're losing or what you're gaining? So in any choice, like let's go back to this girl I was helping on Instagram. What should I do? Should I study, continue study at university, or should I follow my career with horses? Once we've established no one can answer that, she has to answer that, then you have to have the freedom of there's no right or wrong answer. There's only choices. And every choice, there's no right answer here. There's not if you go to university, your life will be fantastic and fabulous and everything will be perfect and it's the right choice. Or alternatively, if you work with horses, that's the fabulous choice. Only things go right there. Only things go well there. You guys get that, yeah? Whatever choice, there's going to be good things and bad things. There's going to be things you get and things you lose. Things you achieve, things you don't. And your job is to then create the freedom of going, I'm just going to do what feels right. I'm going to do the best I can with what I know at the time. So anytime I make a mistake and then, yeah, make a mistake, make a choice, and it turns out to be the wrong choice, I go, I did my best. I did the best I knew. I did the best I could with what I knew at the time. If I knew how to do better, I would have. And it's that mindset of understanding I did my best. It was a shitty best. It was an uneducated best. It was a pathetic best. But it was my best with what I knew at the time. And if I knew how to do better, I would have. And that is not only how I judge myself, but that is how I judge every single human being on the planet. A lot of humans decide to have opinions about other humans, which I find hilarious. Because firstly, as we've established, you don't know that human as well as you think you do, you don't. And secondly, they are doing the best they can with what they know at the time. And it might be a shitty best and it might be a horrible best and it may have hurt others, but they are doing their best. Okay, so I just wanted to get that out there because it's been on my mind and I wanted you to just have that. So now we can get into the dressage. So today I wanted to talk about throughness. So there's been lots of questions, and you know that word, I hated that word when I was learning how to ride. You know, get the horse more through. You could have said get the horse more square, get the horse more triangular, get the horse more piggly diggly. That's what it sounded like to me. I was like, yeah, that's nice. Good for you. What should I do? How would I know I have it? All those kinds of questions. So what I want you guys to realize, firstly, is through is not a button. Your horse is not through and then not through. It's not like you're pregnant or you're not pregnant. Okay, that's a black or white. You can't be a bit pregnant. You're either pregnant or you're not pregnant. Throughness isn't pregnant. Okay, so we can start with a mindset of, that there's a continuum of throughness and there's zero. People are crazy. You're gorgeous. People are doing the best they can with what they know. All right, so we've got 0% on the throughness and we've got 100% on the throughness, okay? And this is our continuum. So if we want to get our positive mindsets out, we can say our horse is already through. It's just at 0% on the throughness scale, but it's through, just not very through, if you want to stay positive about it. Okay, so if your horse is at 0% throughness, don't think, how can I get my horse to 100% throughness? Because 100% throughness, I don't even know. I reckon I've had glimpses of maybe a stride at 100% throughness, but probably not. Because how would I know that it's 100% throughness? Because there might be another level of throughness I've never felt, I've never discovered, I've never understood. So I'm not going to know that that's the border or that's the limit until I get to the next level and go, oh, there was this whole other level. And who's done that in their riding career? They thought they did it good. They thought they did it well. They thought this is it, that this is the throughness or the on the bit or the softness or the suppleness feeling. And then a year later, they ride a different horse or they have another experience. I know people come to our Riding Success Institute and they ride the FEI horses and they go, oh, is this what it's meant to feel like? And it's like, yes, and more and more and more. So you know, there's always another level. So I might argue and say that, you know, Charlotte Giudadon and Isabel Wirth, they're at 100% throughness, but they not might not be at 100% throughness. They're probably still uncovering higher levels, more levels of more that they didn't know existed and that they're uncovering and uncovering. So you first have to get really excited that you're on this continuum that probably never has an end point. But that's also very exciting. And that's when you read the interviews of the dressage masters who've been riding at 70 years, 80 years, 90 years, their entire life. And you know, you go, well, why are you riding? And they're like, because there's still so much to learn. There's still so much to discover. There's still so much to play with. And that's what I've, reconciled in myself. Because when I was learning how to ride, I was very, very frustrated. I just wanted to know the rules. Yeah. And I just wanted to know when I had achieved it. And I just wanted to know when I had arrived, and felt very, very frustrated pretty much all the time because I never really arrived and I never really got it, because as soon as I arrived and as soon as I got it, there was something else that I had to arrive to and somewhere else that I had to get to. So make peace with you'll never get there so you can enjoy the journey. So we're at 0%, we might be at 10%, we might be at 20%, or wherever we are in our throughness continuum. And what does that mean? That to me, throughness is the connection of the hind leg to the front end, okay? And the horse is really through when you feel the back up, when you feel the hind leg active, when you feel the connection, you feel the contact in your hand, but it's not heavy, it's not pulling, but it's not empty. There's a light, soft, uphill connection that you've got with the hand. The horse is reacting off the seat. The hind leg is pumping and, you know, the horse is in front of the leg. Another one of those terms. Remember, the definition of in front of the leg is that the horse feels like it wants to gallop off. It's not galloping off, but it feels like it wants to. It feels like it wants to go forward all the time, even if you're in a reinback, even if you're in a collected pace. And the more you can get that, the more through you are, okay? But then there's also a base level of throughness that every single rider has a standard about. So I have a standard when I get on a horse, or if I'm going to especially ask for a transition, I won't even ask for the transition until I'm at a particular standard of throughness. Now, my standard is, again, different to Isabel and Charlotte's, even though I would love, you know, I'm constantly in my mindset going, I've got to ask for more. I've got to raise that level of standard. That's why we go to lessons. That's when you would go and have a lesson with Isabel and Charlotte. She'd be like, what are you doing? That's not through. And you're like, oh, okay, I've got to find another level. And as much as we try to self-motivate and try and upskill ourselves and try and find that new level ourselves, you know, sometimes we do just need to, you know, have that, you know, or even if we watch a video, I know people in dressage mastery, they'll watch a video and they'll be like, oh, that looks really good. And then my voice will be like, this is not okay. I'm not happy with this. So I'm not going to, you know, ask for the transition until I get the next level. And people go, oh, all right. And then they get back on their horses and they're like, okay, well, I've got to find this next level. Okay, so there's that as well. So think about what your standard is and maybe try and up it by 1%. And then the next thing is, well, how do you get a horse through, or how do you get a horse thrower? And that's not a word, I just made it up. How do you get a horse thrower? But we're talking about our continuum here. Linda's gone, so there might be a degree of completeness. Yes, there always is. You know, well, to me, throughness is like love. Do you love this person completely? Yes. Do you marry them? Yes. But then you might have a child with them, and then people say, oh my God, I thought I loved my wife or my husband, and then I had a child with them, and then I loved them at this whole other level that I never knew existed. Or, you know, they might save a puppy out of a tree, or, you know, take it out of dressage, because you might not have felt it in dressage, but you may have felt it in love. You know, people might have a kid and they go, I never felt true love until I looked at my child for the first time. Whatever it is, there's more love than what you think there is. There's more throughness than what you think there is. There's more fun, I guarantee you that, than what you think there is. Who's ever, you know, had the best night of their life and then 10 years later gone out and then gone, oh my God, this is the best night of my life. There's always another best. There's always another level. So there's that as well. But I also now don't want to discourage you and you go, oh, well, there's always more and, you know, my crap is really crap right now. I'm sure you're screaming at me on the phone going, how do I get my crap better? Or how do I get my through, like, I'm not very through, but I'm on zero. How do I get to 1%? Or how do I get to 10%? Hi, Angie. I'm glad that we can catch each other as well. Okay, so to get your throughness to the next level, you need to think about what are the aids that you're applying, okay? And it's the aids that I keep talking about, and I know you're wanting me to say them differently, but they aren't as complicated as what you think they are. You just, like I gave at the beginning of this talk, you just need to have the freedom to make some choices and to make some mistakes and to make some decisions. I was coaching an amazing rider yesterday and he and I were having a conversation about transitions. And I was like, just stop trying so hard and stop forcing it and just believe and just trust. And the more I could move him into believing that it was going to happen, committing that it was going to happen, but not forcing it to happen, that's where the beauty happened and that's where the magic happened. So how can you take that into your riding as well? And then in terms of throughness, we need the engine. We've always said the first step of getting the horse through is forward, okay? We can't get the horse through if the horse is not active behind. And remember, active behind is the hind leg active. And what is the hind leg active? It's in my word, I say it's pumping. It's not dragging on the floor. So how would you do a lazy walk compared to an active walk? If you're walking and I said, walk more active, what would you do? And you'd probably walk a bit quicker or walk a bit higher. And both those things is more active, okay? So on a three-year-old, we can't expect it to really step higher and use these big muscles to, you know, take us up into passage. So we can't really ask them to take this big high step. So we're going to ask them to take a quicker step, because that will increase the activity of the leg. Same as if you were dragging your legs, walking really slowly, I'd just get you to go, come on, come on, march, quick, quick, quick. And I'd get the activity that way. So that's what we do with the young horse, active, 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 let's go, go, go. But then we don't want the horse flying around, because the minute they just fly around, the minute you start running, where does all the energy go? It goes on the forehand, it goes on the shoulder. And we know as dressage riders, our job is to lift the shoulder and to have zero weight in the shoulder and to have all the weight sitting on the hind leg. We've got to send all the energy and all the weight back there. So we go, okay, how are we going to do that? So it's what I talked about on the horse. We're creating energy, but now we're going to half halt that energy. We're going to block that energy for a second. Not the whole time. We're not going to just now pull on its head, kick it and pull at the same time. We're going to create energy and then we're going to go up. Like we're going to go, we just close our hand and we say, hey, take that energy up and back to the hind leg rather than forward and galloping out on the forehand. Up and back instead of forward and out. Up and back instead of forward and out. We're going to bring our shoulders back. We're going to tense our stomach and we're going to be the anchor, the pole on the carousel horse that is the lever and the strength in this exercise and say, hey, 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 we need you to come back to this. We need you to bring yourself back to here. And the more we send the energy forward, the more we catch the energy and bring it back, the quicker we do that, the better we do that, the more effective we do that, the more throughness we'll have. Okay? Then the other thing that blocks throughness is blocks or stiffness or the horse not being soft and supple. So the horse is hanging on the left or hanging on the right or falling in and dropping his shoulder or falling out and drifting out and making his circles 30 meters instead of 10 meters. So that's when we're also playing with the shoulders. So that's the next level. Once we've got the forward and we've got the half halt, we're playing with the shoulders and we're playing with, is the horse soft and supple between my reins and between where I've got him? So I might need to leg your left, I might need to leg your right, I might need to shoulder in, I might need to traverse, I might need to rombe, I might need to just bend, I might need to just flex, I might need to just apply my inside leg, you know, that inside leg to outside rein, that bend through the body. So yes, I think that's answered. So now what questions do we have? I love it. When I'm talking and there's no questions, it means that I hopefully am communicating correctly. And please know, I'm not perfect, okay? So if you're not getting it, it's on me. It's on me not describing it in a way that you need, or I'm not being who I need to be to help you in this moment. So I need your help. If it's not resonating, if it's not landing, if it's not helping you, let me know, okay? That's my job. My job is to help you. Linda, thank you. That really helped. My pleasure. Good afternoon from Alberta, Canada. Hello, Melanie. Okay, Joe, would you explain the half halt? Yes, I've done a whole video on half halt, and I've done a riding demonstration of the half halt in my previous lives. I think it was, the ride was yesterday, and I don't know what day the half halt was, but I'm sure it's labeled. So you can just go to all our previous lives and check that out. Oh, Sammy, you are gorgeous. Darn close to perfect, my dear. Kiss. How do you know you're doing things right? Perfect question, Joanne. It gets you the outcome. So we talked about in a previous live, you have to be clear on the outcome you want. What is the outcome you want? And then you're just measuring. Everything you do, is this getting me closer to what I want or further away from what I want? The other thing when we're riding horses is you can't get it perfect. You can't ride a three-year-old and get piaffed today. You can't, well, you can if something spooks it. But, you know, you can't ride Grand Prix on a three-year-old. So it's not, you've got an idea of what total perfection looks like. And then it's just, are you 1% closer to that? Because you can't expect the horse to go from 0 to 100% throughness or 0 to 100% piaff or whatever it is in a day. So all I go is I go, am I further away? And sometimes I'm further away, but it's still been a good session. Phil will be like, how was your ride? I'll go, I figured out 500 things that don't work. That's what I did today. Who's had those rides where it's just like, yep, that doesn't work. That didn't work. Ooh, that give a bad reaction. Yep, that's definitely not. It's good. It's good for your learning. You can't know what works until you learn what doesn't work. Thomas Edison, did you fail? Oh my God, you must feel so bad. You failed 10,000 times to invent a light bulb, you loser. No, I'm a freaking genius because I came up with 10,000 ways on how not to invent a light bulb. I successfully achieved 10,000 ways to not invent a light bulb to successfully achieve how to invent a light bulb. That is my training and that is my mindset and that is how I get from nothing to Grand Prix, sometimes without a coach. And sure, it takes longer. Sure, sometimes it's wise and that's what I'm always trying to do. I'm trying to get from coaches or trying to get from people that have a result I don't. All right, what's the cheat sheet? Save me the 10,000 things that I don't have to do. So you can just tell me the one thing that works that will get me the outcome. But when you're riding on your own and you're riding without help, this is you can't then just do the excuse of, so I'll never get there. You will. Is this where our goal setting comes in? Small improvement each day, but aiming for the big picture goal. Absolutely, Emily. Any tips on what to do if the horse argues when you ask them to work correctly? I think I'm doing it wrong because he's starting bucking when I try. I always say if the horse reacts, I must be doing it right. If I'm in the gym and I'm going down 10 centimeters in my squats, like doing really poor, bad quality, bad form squats, And the personal trainer says, do 100. I don't argue. Do, do, do. I'll give you 100 because it's not hard. It's not working. It's not doing anything. Sorry. But if the personal trainer says bum to your heels or, you know, gives me a little low seat that I've got to rest my bum on for a second before I go up and he says, give me 100 squats, I'm going to start complaining. 100? I can't do 100. That's not fair. I'm not doing 100. I'll give you 10 and I'm sitting down. So that's the horse. When the horse is arguing and the horse is going no and the horse is trying to, you know, take off or, you know, change, I always put the horse in a position where he has to work. If the horse is trying to get out of that position, it's a good position. But if the horse is like, yeah, I could do this for 10 hours, it's probably not going to build the muscles you want. It's probably not challenging the border of you and your horse. But again, I just feel I need to do a disclaimer on that. But I So the horse could be really sore, but also the horse could, you know, not physically do it. Like, there's so many things that you've got to go in your head. And again, the horse can't talk. You will be guessing. You will be hypothesizing. You will be trying to put a voice to something, which, you know, like if I say, hi, what does that mean? Does it mean I like you? Does it mean I don't like you? Does it mean I'm pretending? Does it mean I'm saying hi because I have to? Is it meaning that I really like you, but there's something going on with me? How did I say the hi? And what is the meaning behind how I said the hi? And what I did with my eyebrows and what I did with my voice, and because I went up, not down. And what did I do with my mouth? And was I smiling or not smiling? We don't know. We don't know. We will never know what that hi meant. But we have to know. Our brains have to put a label on it. So every single one of you will extrapolate what that means to you based on your previous experiences, based on your values, based on your belief systems, based on your energy, all those kinds of things. Is what we talked about in one of the previous lives. And that's with the training as well. So, you know, we try and cover off our bases. We make sure the physio sees the horse. We make sure the vet sees the horse. We make sure the dentist sees the horse. We make sure the saddle fitter sees the horse. And if there's nothing, then we have to go, okay, well, maybe it's a personal trainer, you know, screw you, personal trainer, I'm not going to do it. And we push the horse and we see what happens. And sometimes, you know, the horse gets stronger and the horse can do it. And we go, okay, that's what it was. Sometimes that doesn't happen. And we go, what is it? Sometimes it's a mindset of the horse. Sometimes the horse just doesn't want to do it ever. It's fine. It's not sore. It just doesn't want to do it. Jane, thank you. Learning a lot. Good. I'm glad. Cool. And remember, guys, we have extended our Easter offer. So if you guys would like to try a lot of my programs, we're giving away my 3 ebooks, part 1 to my Fearless course, my Dressage Mastery course, all about seat and rhythm, and some bonus resources in there for you. We've got goal setting resources in there for you. We've got health resources in there for you. We've got Ecflix, and it's an Ecflix subscription. So it's $9 for 9 days. You can try everything. You get all those $400 worth of bonus resources for you. And then if you want to cancel, you can. If you want to keep going with Ecflix, you can as well. And it's just $9 every 30 days after your $9 trial. So Phil, can you put the link in? Heaps of people have been loving the Easter pack, going, oh my God, this is amazing. And they're getting so much out of it. So I just wanted to mention it. If you guys want some more resources, you're enjoying this conversation, then grab that Easter pack, because you get $400 worth of stuff for $9. And also, it's really cool with Ecflix. I donate 10% of all the membership to a charity of your choice. So we pick a charity every single month. And I'm so excited to find out who we're giving our money to in April. So very, very, very cool. Okay. Do you have an app? Oh, Susan, I love you. Do you know me and computers? I can barely turn one on. We should all be happy that we figured out the technology for life. We will have an app. We're working on it, but remember, we're a very small team. So there's do I make an app or do I come live and help and serve you? I would rather help and serve you here. Cool. All right, so that is today's live. Tomorrow's live is we're back to music and fun. So tomorrow we're just going live on the piano. Sunday morning is my music morning. So Phil and I will be singing songs that you guys can join in. We have also, oh, thank you, Katrina. Awesome offer. Thank you. I hope you're loving it. Yes, so if anyone has any requests, the gorgeous Amanda has actually sent Phil through a request with piano music. So he has been learning the song. What's the song, Phil? From the piano. He can't remember. He's just been learning it. So if you have any requests, private message them through, or make sure you check out the live. If you are interested in dressage help, or you catch me live because you want to learn something dressage-y, give tomorrow a skip. Probably not what you're looking for. But if you want to have some fun, singing is such a great way to lift our spirits, you know, have some fun, get playful, get back into our children, and just have some fun. Come hang out with us tomorrow morning on Sunday. This should be good. See you tomorrow. See you tomorrow, Sammy. Janine, the Easter pack is fantastic and nice. You're so positive. Breath of fresh air. My pleasure, Janine. You know, this is what I live by. I really commit to it. Do I do it 100% of the time? No. Do I do puddle on the floor and feel helpless sometimes? Yes. But after 10 minutes, after an hour, I step back up. I know my happiness and my peace lie are in my control if I control my mindset. So thank you so much that you allow me to share what's going on with me. Marie, I have a YouTube I would like to send to Phil. How do I do it? Just send it to us in private message in your writing success and we will get it. Cool. You guys are loving it. Thank you so much. So that's tomorrow. And then Monday morning, we'll be back with another topic to talk about and Q&A as well. So we are going live. Thank you, Felicia. For the rest of April, we will be going live at this time. So it's 8 a.m. my time, whatever time it is for you. Obviously, this has now been, it's now 8:30. So I go live for half an hour every single day. So at 8 a.m., so 30 minutes previous to now is when I am live. So every morning, 7 days a week, you can check that out and be part of it. Awesome. Angie, thanks for your excellent advice. I'm going to make my way through the lives I've missed. Awesome. Thank you. And remember, anyone who hosts a watch party on any of my lives, send through a screenshot and we're giving away free books. So a free ebook to anyone who does a watch party. So that's my gift to you because thank you for sharing my message and helping other people get what they need in their dressage journeys. And also remember, I would really appreciate if you're loving the lives. What I would really appreciate is a like, follow and subscribe on my social media channels. So go over to YouTube, type in your writing success and click subscribe. That way you'll get notified whenever I go live and whenever I release a new video. Go to Facebook, go to your writing success and click like. That way you'll know when I'm going live and you'll get connected with everything we post on there. And Instagram, we are new to Instagram, but we have some really cool things planned for Instagram. So go over to Instagram, type in your writing success and click follow. Awesome, awesome. When are you going next live? I'm going live every single day. So every 24 hours, half an hour previous to now. So 8 a.m. my time. Basically, come on this time every day and I will be here. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Great. 8 a.m. is great before work. Awesome. All right. Love you guys. Stay safe. All my love. And remember, I'm here for you guys. If you need anything, reach out. Let me know what you need. We're totally here for you. All right. Lots of love. Have a great day. Bye. I have a fat finger and I can't.